Yo, what's going on, Serpa Squad? Tanner here, and I'm back with something a little different. Let's go back 22 years. The year was 1999, and like most kids at the time, my brother and I had the Pokémon bug. We played the games, collected the cards, watched the show, and to this day, Pokémon Gold is still one of my favorite games. Since then, I've collected the cards on and off. I started again in the beginning of 2020, and I'm still doing it today. My wife and I also just finished playing through Pokémon Let's Go Eevee. It was a lot of fun and her first exposure to the series. I've made countless terrariums on this channel, and I even went as far as putting one in my computer desk. However, you've never seen me make a themed terrarium. In case you don't know, Pokémon is absolutely huge right now. It's the 25th anniversary of the series, interest in the cards is at an all-time high, and today is Pokémon Day. I wanted to pay tribute, be a part of the fun, and what better way to do that than with a terrarium. To make this design special, I'll include a variety of Pokémon found in forested areas. I'll carve them out of this sculpture block. It's a foam material that's easy to shape with saws, files, and sandpaper. The first thing I did was draw the Pokémon. I scanned these into the computer so I could adjust the scale. I tried to keep things accurate to the Pokédex entries, but I had to take a few liberties. I cut out blocks of foam and transferred the drawings with carbon paper. Let's get these things carved out. I start with the basic outline. Then I go back and gradually add the features. In some cases, I had to carve the pieces separately and glue them together afterward. With everything carved, we can get them painted. I'll start with a base layer of gesso. I put each Pokémon on a toothpick and got to work. Now for the actual paint. I'm using various acrylic paints that I'll mix up to achieve the appropriate hues. I find it easiest to paint layers, starting with the interior details. In this way, I can clean things up with the subsequent layers. As I said, these will be going into a terrarium where conditions are constantly humid. To protect my art, I applied a few coats of matte clear finish. I chose a few of my favorites, including Parasect, Victory Bell, and Sudowoodo. I also took the opportunity to give the Bulbasaur line some love, since it usually doesn't. I had to give Generation 2 a nod as well with Chikorita. I figured it made sense to include Ekans, since the channel often features reptiles. I added Oddish and Execute for different pops of color. You can't make anything Pokemon related without including Pikachu. I know, not a plant type, but they can be caught in Viridian Forest, so close enough. Oh wait, there's one more! Just a friendly reminder to like and subscribe. Anyway, let's make the terrarium. I'll be using this lamppost globe to match the look of a Pokeball. To keep it in a good position, I glued this blue lid to the bottom. For the foundation of the terrarium, I have sand for the false bottom, charcoal to keep it fresh, and my tropical substrate mix. As for the scape, I'll keep it simple with exclusively Mupani wood. Gotta make sure there's room for the Pokemon, so I only added a few. I'll bring the scape to life with an assortment of random plants from other builds. I put them all in a central location in the background to leave room. You know I couldn't make a terrarium like this without the good stuff. I gathered this immaculate collection of moss from outside. I placed it throughout to make a beautiful carpet. It's looking good, but there's room for one more plant, oakleaf creeping fig. The last thing I need to add are springtails. These will keep the terrarium clear of mold. Sudowoodo is not going to be happy about it, but I gave the terrarium a quick misting as well. Prior to adding the Pokémon, I covered the toothpick holes with hot glue. The final element needed is a lid. To go along with the theme, I decided to make a Pokeball covering. I followed the same process from earlier other than applying gesso. Happy birthday, Pokemon! Here's your terrarium. I had so much fun making this project and video. I really hope you all enjoyed it. My hope is that it took many of you down memory lane to a different time. I know it did for me, especially when I got out my old Gameboy and other items. I know it's not the usual, but I like switching it up from time to time. If you like this sort of thing, I can definitely do more themed projects in the future. Let me know in the comments. Totally random, but I have a feeling that many of you want to see my cards now. If that's the case, I could potentially do a video about them on the second channel. I also got some Shining Fates ETBs, so maybe I can open a pack or two on there as well. Also, if you're looking for more nostalgia, I'll link up my brother's channel in the video description. He does video game covers and remixes, and just did one for Pokemon. Anyway, that's all I have for you in this one. Again, I really hope y'all enjoyed it and learned something new. Until next time, Serpa Squad, take care, and peace, Pikachu!